Climatic and anthropogenic influences are changing watersheds in the Rocky Mountain region. Most stream water in the Rocky Mountains and Colorado Front Range comes from the seasonal snowpack that accumulates in high elevations throughout the winter. In recent decades, there has been a dramatic increase in nitrogen use from agricultural fertilizer and fuel emissions, causing nitrogen-saturated hotspots along the Front Range. These nitrogen-saturated hotspots have a huge impact on aquatic organisms and can lead to increased algae growth, resulting in the eutrophication of these pristine alpine environments.
Yeah, so my area of research is mountain hydrology and biogeochemistry, and in particular in areas that are snow-covered and ice-covered. So some of the research programs I'm involved with right now today, one is the Niwot Ridge LTER program. Yeah, in terms of anthropogenic influences, sort of an approximate way what's happening today, it's increases in nitrogen deposition, and that is deposition of inorganic nitrogen, which is ammonium plus nitrate. And over the last 25 years, we've documented that that's increased about 400%. And the bottom line is alpine areas have very little tolerance to deal with that excess nitrogen. And so what's happened in a number of areas, including Green Lakes Valley, which is the water source for the city of Boulder, those ecosystems have switched from N-limited to N-saturated. And that's a really big change. So what's kind of unique about alpine environments is that we have long snow duration season. That is, the snow starts to accumulate on the ground without melting in October or so, and high elevation doesn't really start melting until May. And so what's happening is all the water in snowfall during those 6, 7, 8 months is accumulated, but not only the water, all the solutes that are in that snowfall and that are blowing in on dust and dry deposition are accumulated over the 6 or 8 month time period, which is very different than a rain event. And then they're released all at once. And we know that we have fairly high DIN content in the seasonal snowpack, and then that's released over a very short time span.
I look at how vegetation responds to water inputs, and also, conversely, how vegetation influences subsurface flow paths and in the broader water cycle. Vegetation really is sort of the conduit that connects the surface to the atmosphere. So there's just constant interaction back and forth. So one of the areas that I focused on locally within the Boulder Creek CZO has been the mid to lower elevation sites. So these are ponderosa pine, or ponderosa pine and lodgepole pine dominated sites. And so much of our research has been focused, especially in Colorado, much of our research has been focused on snow dominated systems, on the subalpine forest. This has been because snowpack is what we rely on for our annual water supply. The proportion spatially of subalpine to our lower elevation montane ecosystems, most of our area actually falls within this montane ecosystem. And a very small amount of our forested area actually falls into this subalpine ecosystem. So despite the fact that subalpine systems are incredibly important for water, when we look at the potential climate change impacts, they're going to have a bigger spatial impact on these lower elevation sites than the higher elevation sites.
It is important to understand changes in water chemistry and aquatic vegetation in watersheds along the Colorado Front Range because these high mountain watersheds are a valuable water source for over 1 million people along the Front Range urban corridor.